This week on Maker Update, stopping to smell the abstract paintings, elevating your shop storage, bubble wrap bling bags, precise sheet metal parts, automatic wire cutting, and reverse engineering a 3D scan. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Maker Update. I'm Tyler Weingunner. I hope you're all doing well and staying cozy. Hopefully you've got some fun projects to tackle for the winter. I've been busy with the rest of the team getting all the last minute stuff ready for Maker Faire Rochester that's coming up this weekend. If you're in the area, come check it out. But if you're not, we've still got a great show for you, so let's check out the project of the week. There's a lot of great projects coming up in the show, but the one I just couldn't stop thinking about is this wearable light painting visualizer that turns scents into abstract paintings by Four Eyes Six Senses. We do love a good generative art project, and ideally, the weirder the better. And I just adore the idea of using an AI nose to make art. This project is a sort of remix or mashup of two other projects. Benjamin Cabe's 3D printed AI nose, which uses an electronic gas sensor to detect scents, a tiny ML neural network to process the data, and a Wio terminal to display the detected scent. The other is Shawn Hymel's Sensor Fusion AI nose project, which uses a number of different gas sensors and a temperature sensor to detect a broader range of scents. This version uses the Grove multi-channel gas sensor in a 3D printed nose that's attached to the wearer's finger. As it detects different scents, abstract patterns are displayed on the Wio terminal's screen. The color changes depending on the scents detected, and the circle increases in size as the identification confidence grows. He's then using a light painting app to capture the output and turn them into abstract paintings. It's a weird sort of combination of inputs to create generative art, but it's fun and ripe for future adaptation. I saw in another video on his YouTube channel that he's built a similar device to visualize electromagnetic fields and turn those into light paintings. Almost like a video version of the classic ElectroSolush project that turns electromagnetic fields into sounds. There's no instructable for that one, but you can find a full bill of materials and project instructions for the AI Nose Visualizer down in the description. We've got some more projects for you. Whether you have a big workshop or a small one, the thing that always seems true is that you never have enough wall space for storage. In a recent video, April Wilkerson made use of her shop's high ceilings to build a shelving unit that could lift up and out of the way to reveal more storage behind it. Almost like those racks at your hardware store, but vertical. It uses an electric hoist to lift up the shelf, and it stays on track using rollers from her garage door. The shelving unit itself is modular, so if she wants to make changes to it down the road, it shouldn't be too difficult. It may not be practical for everyone's space, but she has plans for it if you want to build your own. On Instructables, CMoz has a guide to making a clutch bling bag out of bubble wrap fabric and a short strip of RGB LEDs. Bubble wrap fabric is a sewable material made of several layers of heat-pressed bubble wrap. It's sturdy, it has a unique look, and it makes great diffusion material for colored lights. An Adafruit Gemma M0 controls all the lights, while some patches of conductive fabric add touch interactivity, like turning the LED strip on and off and cycling the animation. She also has another instructable that shows you how to make the bubble wrap fabric, so give that a look as well. I was also super impressed with this DIY wire cutter by MrInnovative. At the start of the video, you see the control interface, where you can set the length of the wire you want, and how much insulation to trim off at each end, and how many wire segments you need. There's a stepper motor to control the wire feed, and another to manipulate the cutter. But I think my favorite part is, for as high-tech as this looks, how decidedly lo-fi the cutter mechanism is. It's literally a cheap wire cutter and stripper hand tool. There's a servo that moves the wire from the cut position to the notch to strip the insulation off. Despite all that, it looks really well built and cleverly thought out. There's even a turnbuckle to help you fine-tune the depth of cut for your wire. There's a link with the wiring diagram, code, and 3D printed files down in the description. Time for some tips and tools on his channel. Ben Krasnow has a thorough video detailing his process of DIY photochemical machining. This is a process that you can use to chemically etch metal to create incredibly detailed thin metal parts. Unfortunately, there aren't any vendors offering this type of fabrication for hobbyists or small businesses, so Ben developed his own process. It's still fairly complex with a number of custom-built machines for each step of the process, but it looks like you could probably follow his work if you need to make parts like this. Ben also offers a ton of great tips in this video for making really effective transparencies, which is useful for everything from screen printing to circuit etching. Caleb Kraft has a video out on how he used a fairly cheap diode laser to create a DIY SLS printer using powdered sugar. This sort of machine has existed in a few different iterations for a while now, but this was something Caleb just needed to try out, so it's pretty hacky. He 3D printed a box with a lifting tray for the sugar and just lowered the bed and added the sugar by hand. The real process of discovery is figuring out the right arrangement of power and speed and the right material. Powdered sugar reflected too much of the laser light, but hot cocoa mix worked pretty well. It's not exactly going to replace any of your purchased 3D printers, but it's a fun experiment. Great Scott has a video about a versatile charging board that enables you to create your own custom high-powered battery banks that can deliver a variety of voltages and wattages. His first step with it is to do a bit of exploration to understand the supplied datasheet, which was in Chinese. And then did a bunch of testing to verify everything before trying to create his own power bank. I know that working with large battery packs like this can be an iffy proposition, but it seems like a handy board to know about if you know what you're doing, since most store-bought battery banks can't supply 100 watts. And finally, Making for Motorsport has a fascinating video on how you can use a 3D scanner to reverse engineer a part so you can model it and redesign it in Fusion 360. This is a multi-step process that begins with scanning the part. He's using an off-the-shelf scanner, but you might be able to pull this off using photogrammetry if you took enough photos. His next step is to clean up any unnecessary details using mesh mixer. Stuff like manufacturer stamping or sprues from the casting process. Next up is aligning the part to the desired coordinate system. But the real work begins after bringing the model into Fusion. One of the coolest tools he uses, which I'd never heard about before, lets you create a sketch from a cross-section of a mesh, and then uses that sketch to create parametric geometry. There's a ton of great techniques throughout this video. Give it a watch. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're coming all the way back to machine learning with this helpful guide to feature selection by Shawn Hymel. Feature selection is just a fancy way of identifying which data your machine learning model needs to track to correctly identify your subjects. That way you can simplify your project. It's especially handy for embedded machine learning since it will reduce computation, which saves power. And it can even reduce the number of sensors you'll need. There's a lot of heady concepts in here, but if you're already stuck in with machine learning and you're ready to optimize, this seems like a useful video. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. I hope you had a great time with this one. If you did, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, maybe even hit subscribe. Maybe? As always, big thanks to DigiKey for making this whole show possible, and to you for watching. Take care, we'll see you soon.